Reproducibility in machine learning is super important. In this special build edition of the AI Show, we will hear from Dennis A. Kalamboom, program manager on the Azure Machine Learning team. He's going to talk all about tracking in Azure Machine Learning through a very interesting demo. Make sure you tune in.
Hello, and welcome to the session on data to machine learning tracking. My name is Dennis, and I'm a program manager on the Azure Machine Learning team. Maintaining a digital audit trail for your machine learning activities matters. It enables experiment reproducibility and improves the operability of your machine learning solutions. Legislative reasons might also be an important driver to keep track of your assets. For this demo, we'll take a look at the analytics company Contoso that provides services to renters on the Amsterdam housing market. Since the market is saturated and changing rapidly, the company helps renters to find the optimal price for their properties. In their analysis, they make use of both static reference data as well as data that is coming in live from housing reviews. There are two main drivers for Contoso why tracking is important. First, because prices fluctuate, they want to include the latest data in their models and hence retrain and redeploy often. Each time they make a pricing recommendation, they would like to understand what model version was used and which data was included. Secondly, when customers sign up for the services of Contoso, they agree that their data might be used for analytical purposes. From a legal perspective, they might sometimes receive a request to delete the data that was used due to European law. I will now show you how Azure Machine Learning enables Contoso to keep track of the various assets that go in and out of the experimentation process, like code, data, and models as a result, and how those are used more downstream in the various stages of the machine learning lifecycle.
At Contoso, the data engineering and data science teams work closely together. Contoso's data engineers collect live data from random reviews that people post online, and then the data science team use the data as input to several of their machine learning experiments. Let's have a closer look at one of their pipelines. Data is captured via an Azure event hub, and the team uses Spark structured streaming to add static reference data as the reviews stream in. Since data comes in a JSON format, the team applies pre-processing logic to set the schema of the columns and then collect the results in a table for easier downstream processing. You can see that rental reviews are posted continuously. Browsing over them, we can see that reviews contain information regarding the neighborhood, specifications of the apartment, its rental price, and the satisfaction scores that people gave regarding their stays. Contoso's data science team has issued a survey with local guides on the perceived sentiment of renting a place in each of the different Amsterdam neighborhoods. One of the metrics that the survey yielded is a score for the relative closeness of a neighborhood to the airport. The team captured the survey results in a table. The data engineering team uses the reference table with the survey results to enrich each of the reviews that come in and then write the stream to storage for later analysis. The data science team builds on Azure Machine Learning to run the machine learning experimentation and deployment. Whenever the team makes a change to the data that is used as input to their experiment, they will define a new dataset version. Using Azure Machine Learning datasets, they define a reference to the data on storage, allowing them to use it as a version input to their machine learning pipeline. In this notebook, the team defines a new dataset version to include the most recently collected data points. Note that when creating a dataset with Azure Machine Learning, we define a data reference, whereas the actual data remains in the source. By registering the dataset, we make it available for others to use. One of the experiments that the data science team carries out is the determination and advice for a rental price of an apartment, given its characteristics, ratings, and time of year. The team learned that to prevent the model from drifting quickly, they would need to incorporate new data relatively frequent. Hence, they would make a new dataset version in the same way as we saw before, and reference that dataset version for training. In order to do so, they would simply make a reference to the dataset in the training script using the Azure Machine Learning SDK, provide a version, and then pass the dataset along for training. in this case using an AutoML run. As we iterate on versions, it is easy to lose track on which dataset version was used as an input to what experiment run. Therefore, when we submit a run using Azure Machine Learning, several metadata is tracked for us. This includes the datasets that we passed along to our experiment, Git tracking information, our particular experiment configuration in terms of parameters, as well as any metrics that we might have collected during training. Next to the inputs to our experiment run, Azure Machine Learning also helps keep track of outputs. For this particular run, you can see that one model was registered, for example, when we finalized the run. In Azure Machine Learning, we can register a model as an asset that can be versioned and tracked for its usage. Similar to the tracking details that we saw for the experiment run pages, the model registry captures all of the metadata associated with your model, including the experiment that was used for model training, tags that we might add to the model. As well, we can find an overview of the endpoints where a model is deployed for scoring. To sum everything up, from the inferencing endpoint displayed here, Contoso is able to track what model version was used for a rental advice. They can trace this version back to a particular experiment, as well as to a particular version of their input dataset. And then from the dataset's definition, they can lineage back the raw files that define the version.
In this session, we looked at the tracking capabilities in Azure Machine Learning. To recap, keeping well track of your assets is important for a variety of reasons. For most, the ability to reproduce the same outcome during experimentation matters. It enables us to replicate specific results we obtained in the past, as well it allows others to build forward on existing work. There might also be legal constraints that your team needs to comply with. Audit or legislative requirements, like GDPR, have increased the importance for teams to keep well track of their assets. From an operational standpoint, tracking helps you identify the impact of issues as they might arise with data or models in production. For example, you might find out that a data quality issue caused the model version to start to produce incorrect outcomes. Thanks to tracking, you might identify that in practice, multiple model versions were impacted by the same corrupt dataset. Whatever your motivation is to track, keep in mind that Azure Machine Learning can help you to simplify this job with its tracking capabilities.